dear friends and aspirants, welcome back to my channel High Point. So I hope you are following my videos and you have subscribed to my channel. Don't forget to subscribe if you have not yet subscribed. So yeah, I hope you are doing great in your life and moving slowly to your UGC NET JRF dreams, and I hope for the best for you guys. And now in this video we are going to learn about Thomas Piatt and Earl of Surrey. So we cannot forget them when we are looking at the literature of the age of revival, and they are often Thomas Piatt and Earl of Surrey. They were pronounced together all the time. So let's see what are their life events and also their contributions to literature as such. So Thomas Piatt, he lived from 1503 to 1542, and Earl of Surrey from 1516 to 1547. Now, first of all, let's see about Thomas Piatt. Thomas Piatt, he was a court poet of Henry the seventh of the age of revival. So remember about Thomas Piatt and Earl of Surrey, the primary thing that you have to remember about them is that both of them belong to the age, what age of revival. So Thomas Piatt and Earl of Surrey, so especially Thomas Piatt, so in during that period of time we can see emergence of new court poet. So Thomas Piatt was one among them, and Thomas Piatt, he is a court poet in the court of Henry the seventh of the age of revival, and he is often known as the pioneer of new English poetry. So English was slowly assuming its modern form after the age of Chaucer, right? So you know, he emerged as a court poet. He translated many works, and he even introduced the sonnet form into English that we will see later. And he is often known as the pioneer of new English poetry. So if ever a question asked about who is known as the pioneer of new English poetry in the question paper of UGC NET, then you have to answer it as Thomas Piatt, who lived in the age of revival. And he introduced the sonnet form in English. Okay, sonnet is from Italy, right? Petrarch is the major proponent of sonnet, and from Italy he introduced the sonnet form into English. And let's see some details about Thomas Piatt's life. Okay, first of all, he was born at Allington in 1503. So in the place known as Allington he was born, and he was one of the advisors of the king. So Thomas Piatt, he was politically very vibrant, and he had a very nice political life, and he was one of the advisors of the king, and he got education at St. John's College and University of Cambridge. In John's College he had his education, and he married to Elizabeth Brooke in 1520. So in 1520 he was married to Elizabeth Brooke, and he held various political offices for Henry the Eighth. Okay, for Henry the Eighth he held various eminent political offices. And Piatt was rumored to have a close relation with Lady Anne Boleyn. So there is a lady known as Lady Anne Boleyn. There was a rumor that Piatt had a very close relation with Lady Anne Boleyn. But in 1533, Lady Boleyn and Henry the Eighth got married. Okay, and this union was devastated Piatt. So he was not at all happy with the union between Lady Boleyn and Henry the Eighth. So he wrote a work known as Whose List to Hunt. From this background, sitting in this background, he wrote a work known as Whose List to Hunt. And he was knighted. Piatt was knighted in 1535, and he served. Piatt served the king from 1537 to 1539 as an ambassador to the court of Holy Roman Emperor. Okay, so he served as an ambassador from 1537 to 1539, and in 1541 he was charged with treason by Edmund Bonner, the Bishop of London. So what happened to him? In 1541 he was charged with treason by Edmund Bonner, the Bishop of London, and in his confinement. So after that he got arrested, and also in his confinement he wrote an impassioned defense in defense of himself. To get rid of or get out of this confinement, he wrote an impassioned defense, and he After that he was released from the confinement, and later in 1542 Viatu traveled in ill health in a diplomatic mission, and on the way he was affected by a fever and died. After some time he died. So in 1542 Viatu was traveling in ill health in a diplomatic mission. So he was on a diplomatic mission and he was traveling when his health is not too good, and on the way he caught with a fever and he died thereafter. So that was the life of Thomas Viatu. Now let's see literary career and his contributions. Okay, so Viatu's first published work was Certain Sams. Do you remember this? His first published work was Certain Sams, and his constant travel to Italy made him familiar with the sonnets of Petrarch. So sonnet, mainly major proponent of sonnet is Petrarch. Okay, Petrarch is from Italy. So his constant travels to Italy on diplomatic missions for the king made him familiar with the sonnet form of Petrarch, and he got ideas to regenerate English poetry. So from there, by becoming familiar with sonnet form of Petrarch from Italy, he got some ideas to regenerate, bring life to English poetry again. He translated several Petrarchan sonnets into English, hence bring it into English. As he was translating several Petrarchan sonnets into English, he brought sonnet form into English. While he used love themes and conceits from Petrarch, Viatu deviated from the rhyme scheme. He used love scenes and conceits from Petrarch as such, but he deviated from the rhyme scheme. So he deviated from the rhyme scheme that Petrarch used while he was translating all those sonnets of Petrarch into English. Petrarchan sonnet, as we all know, contains an octave rhyming AB, BA, AB, BA. Okay, so Petrarchan sonnet contains an octave. Octave means eight lines stanza, and the rhyme scheme of that octave is AB, BA, AB, BA. And it followed by a turn, by a sestet. Sestet contains 6 lines. Okay, so it is followed by a turn, by a sestet with various rhyme schemes. So what does he do? Actually, he maintained the octave, but sestet scheme was different when he translated Petrarchan sonnets to English. So we have employed the Petrarchan octave. So he retained the Petrarchan octave, but his most common sestet scheme was CD, DC, EE. So he deviated there. When he composed the sestets of the sonnets, he deviated from Petrarch while he maintained the octave, and his most common scheme that he employed was CD, DC, EE. So mainly he introduced the form from Italy to English, or from Petrarch to English. Then in addition to the translations of the works by Seneca and Horace, he experimented with the stanza form. So his main experimentation was in the form. Okay, so he experimented with the stanza form, and he also translated works of Seneca. Seneca is a great tragedian, and Horace is a great philosopher also. So Seneca and Horace. So in the verse of David Dages, we can see that it is with Thomas Viatu that modern English poetry can be seen to begin. So this comment was made by David Dages, and he claims that, with Thomas Viatu, it is modern poetry. The real beginning of modern poetry can be seen with Thomas Viatu. And Viatu's experiments with the sonnet form and stanza forms marked the beginning of an exclusively English contribution to sonnet structure, that is three quatrains and a close couplets. So his main experiments were in the session of stanza forms, different kind of stanza forms. So that experiments actually marked the beginning of an exclusive English sonnet form, or an exclusive English sonnet structure that contains three quatrains. Quatrains means four line stanzas, three quatrains and a closing couplet with two lines. So that is the sonnet structure. English sonnet structure is three quatrains and one closing couplet. So that form was derived by Viatu as he was experimenting with different kind of sonnet forms. or stanza forms. So that's all about Thomas Piatt. Now let's see what about Earl of Surrey. Earl of Surrey, his real name is Henry Howard. So Earl of Surrey is a title name, and Earl of Surrey's real name is Henry Howard, and he lived from 1516 to 1547. So he was a court poet like Thomas Piatt. Earl of Surrey is also a court poet, and he was born in Hunsdon, Hertfordshire, England. So he was born in Hunsdon and Hertfordshire. So Hunsdon is a place in Hertfordshire and England. And Henry took the courtesy of the title of Earl of Surrey in the year 1524. So he took this title, Earl of Surrey, in the year 1524. And he lived an eventful life as a soldier and as a courtier. So he was both a soldier and a courtier. So he had a very vibrant and eventful life as a soldier and as a courtier. And he married to Lady Frances de Vere. So later in his life, when he was young, he was married to Lady Frances de Vere. And he stayed in the French court for nearly a year. In 1533, as a member of the entourage of the French king. So he stayed in the French court. So for a period of time, approximately for a year in 1533, he stayed in French court as a member of the entourage of the French king. So the French king had a group of people for making some tours inside the country. So he stayed there in French court as a member of that entourage of the French king for more than a year, approximately nearly a year, in the year 1533. The year 1536 was a significant year in his life. Surrey served with his father in quelling the pilgrimage of Grace Rebellion, which protested against the king's dissolution of the monasteries. So king was actually dissoluting monasteries. So a protest was there, a rebellion was there, going on against the action of the king, that is dissolution of the monasteries. So in 1536, Surrey actually supported his father in the pilgrimage of Grace Rebellion. So that rebellion was against the king's action of dissolution of the monasteries. And for this reason, he was later confined at Windsor. So he was later confined at Windsor in between the year 1537 to 39. So for participating and supporting his father in pilgrimage of Grace Rebellion, he was confined at Windsor from 1537 to 39. And Surrey was soon back to the favor and made Knight of Garter in 1541. So what happened? So after that, soon Surrey get back to the favor of the king, and he made Knight of Garter. So after that, he made a Knight of Garter in the year 1541 and served as a soldier in France. So Earl of Surrey served as a soldier in France after he was made of Knight of Garter in 1541. When Henry VIII health was failing in 1546, Surrey made a mistake of announcing his opinion of the obviousness of his father becoming protector to young Prince Edward. So this was a huge mistake that caused his father's and his life himself. Now, when Henry VIII was the king. So Henry VIII health was declining in 1546. Surrey made a foolish comment. Or Surrey actually announced his opinion because his son, Henry VIII's son Edward, was so young. So he made an opinion that his father is going to be, obviously his father is going to be the protector to young Prince Edward. So such a comment that he made before the death of, so it's not advisable that you make such comments when the king's health is declining and the prince is there. So nobody can predict what is going to happen, right? So Henry VIII, he consumed by paranoia, and he convinced that Surrey had planned to usurp the crown from his son Edward. So since he commented like that, he opined like that his father is going to be the protector to young Prince Edward, Henry VIII's health is declining, and he was consumed by paranoia because of that, and he assumed that Surrey is planning to usurp the crown from, or Sarai is going to snatch the crown from his son Edward. So the king imprisoned both the father and the son, that Sarai and his father, and finally Sarai was beheaded for treason in, Sarai and his father, both of them were beheaded for treason in 1547. Okay, this was happened in the year 1547. Now, let's see what are the literary career, what is his literary career and what are the contributions of Sarai in the literature of English. Most of his poetry published after his death. So, most of the poetry were published posthumously, and his name is often cited together with Wyatt, Thomas Wyatt, as both of them fathered English sonnet form. So, Thomas Wyatt and Earl of Surrey, both of them fathered English form. Since one introduced the form, another one, like Surrey, gave the metrical scheme for sonnet form of English. So, both of them are together always. Their names often cited together as they both fathered English sonnet form. And Sarai is the first to develop the sonnet form used by William Shakespeare. So, William Shakespeare is the one who actually popularized this form by writing 154 sonnets in this particular form. So, Sarai is the first to develop that form which was used by William Shakespeare. And he also translated two books of Virgil's Aeneid. Okay, two books of Virgil's Aeneid. And while he was translating, he used the blank words for the first time in English. So, he's the one who first time used blank words in English. Many believe that it is Christopher Marlowe. Christopher Marlowe popularized the form blank words. Okay. Popularized blank words by composing his tragedies his plays in blank words. But, as Sarai was translating Virgil's Aeneid, two books of Virgil's Aeneid, he made the first use of blank words in English. Okay, do remember that. And he improved the versification of Wyatt's sonnets. So, another thing that he did was that he improved, he updated and he upgraded the versification of Wyatt's sonnets, and he gave rhyming meter to the sonnet form introduced by Wyatt. So, mainly Wyatt's experiments were about the sonnet form and the stanza form of sonnet and all. But it was Sarai, Earl of Sarai, who gave rhyming meter to the sonnet form introduced by Wyatt. And he experimented with variety of meters. So, Wyatt experimented with the stanza forms, while Sarai experimented with a variety of meters. So, these are some of the contributions made by Sarai and also Thomas Wyatt. Please remember these contributions, and please remember that Sarai is the one who introduced blank verse and used blank verse for the first time in English as he was translating two books of Virgil's Aeneid. And he also gave rhyming meter to the form developed, the sonnet form developed by Wyatt, and he's the one who developed the sonnet form used by William Shakespeare, which is also known as Shakespearean sonnet form or English sonnet form. So that's all about major literary contributions made by Wyatt and Sarai. Remember some little details about them. I have seen plenty of questions related to Wyatt and Sarai in the previous question paper, and they are relevant when we consider the age of revival as well. So, like always, if you have not subscribed to my channel, please subscribe for more details, more contents related to UGC NET English Language and Literature. And also, please, if you have any doubts, suggestions, queries, questions, and if you want me to make any contents related to UGC NET English Language and Literature, do that. Mention all these things, mention in the comment section, and go and visit my website www.highpoint.in, where you will get immense material to have a systematic study for your UGC NET, JRF and English. If you want any further help, you can obviously message me or WhatsApp me or call me in the WhatsApp number given in the screen. And also you can message me in email via email using this mail ID. And also you can join a WhatsApp group where you will get immense amount of topics, an immense amount of materials in the form of capsules, in the form of daily quizzes, in the form of marathon quizzes. You will get many details related to and many news related to UGC NET JRF through that WhatsApp group. You can click the link given in the description box and also join the WhatsApp group if you want. If your friends are interested, you can also share this link to them so that they could join. So that's all about it. Let me meet you in the next video. Until then, bye-bye. Thank you.